Minesweeper. That one Windows minigame everybody accidentally opened as a kid, clicked randomly, blew up, and never touched the game. It's a classic puzzle game that dates back in the 1960s. The rules of the games are pretty simple. Click a tile, hope it's not a bomb, use the numbers to deduce where the rest of the bombs are, and click all of the non-bomb tiles. So yeah, I play a lot of Minesweeper. Like, a lot. It's my go-to, I need to feel smart but also want to suffer game. I even have it on my phone. And sure, there are tons of Minesweeper clones out there. Apps, websites made by people way smarter than me, but none of them really hit the sweet spot for me. I like the feeling of playing on Minesweeper.online, but it only has light skin and dark skin. On the other hand, Minesweeper Retro app on my phone has plenty of skins. Look, it even has this one with poop as the mine. But it's a mobile app. And I want something that feels clean and lets me customize the theme so I can make it look like it has RTX on or use the Amongus theme. So as a computer science student with a deeply unhealthy need to reinvent the wheel, I obviously decided to write my own Minesweeper so that I can achieve the ultimate flex. Minesweeper with RTX on. And of course, Amongus. Before I could even dive into the code abyss, I had to make a few big brain decisions. Step 1, choose a programming language. Now, most sane people would pick something like C++, Python, or even Unity C#. For me, I chose Zig. Why? Because I hate myself, apparently. But seriously though, Zig is a low-level, fast, and serious language, and it has tons of bindings for a lot of game engines, which relates to the next step, that is, picking a game engine. Yes, I am using a game engine.
But wait, don't you like the suffering? Why not write your own engine? Your mom is going to be so disappointed if she knows about-
Shut up, man. Shut up. Anyway, so I went with Raylib. And honestly, I don't have a reason, but we'll see how it goes. And that's it. That is the prep. Two choices now will dictate how much I suffer in the coming few days. Let's go. Before I get RTX Minesweeper running, I need to first write a normal classic Minesweeper. And to do that, I need to render some textures on the screen. Fortunately, Raylib makes it really easy. Not a sponsor, by the way. I just need to find a sprite image, load the sprite, define a rectangle region on the sprite, and draw it on the screen. And there we go. A single tile. That was pretty easy, right? It only took me like 2 hours. Anyway, now I can render one tile. Drawing other types is pretty easy. I just need to change the rectangle region on the sprite image to the right place and draw it on the screen. Then I can finally start generating a whole board. So I'm gonna make a virtual representation of the game board using an array, with each element being a struct called tile. I'll store info like the type, position, just some typical object-oriented stuff. I'm also tracking whether tiles are being clicked or not. This is done by checking if the left mouse button is pressed and if the mouse position is within the tile's boundaries. If it is, then I render the click sprite. And now I can click tiles. Oh. Yeah, I haven't calculated the numbers yet. Quickly implement those. Okay, that is not it. Let's try it again. Bro, what the f*** is this?
Oh my
what?
God.
Why is
I'm
it
not
going
show me
what the hell
I
can
do
to
Okay, finally, a working classic Minesweeper. And there are a couple of interesting details I noticed when writing it. For example, instead of expanding the tile immediately when the mouse is pressed, I need to check if the mouse is released to get a classic feel of the game. This also helps in the scenario where the player accidentally holds down the mouse button. So yeah, that was pretty fun, thinking about the little details of the game that I play all the time. But before diving into the RTX graphics, I want to add a simple UI to display debug information or timer. For this, I'm using the dear IMGUI. Anyway, I thought it was going to be easy to integrate into my project since Raylib already uses the backend to render graphics. But surprise surprise, it was very difficult. I did find a library called RLAmGUI which solved some of the integration problems for me, but I still spent hours trying various methods to make it work. In the end, I discovered I needed to use the Zig package called ZGUI to get AmGUI bindings, compile RLAmGUI using Zig's build system, include it via cinclude, and pray, and then it finally worked. All of this would have been so much easier if I was programming in C. Bruh. And I know I've probably done this in the wrong way, so if there is any Zig Master, let me know in the comment, man. And voila! Now I have a beautiful UI to make this program a little bit more professional, so I can cover the bullshit underneath. Oh, and by the way, I've added several features such like the ability to scale the whole board. When I was still using Windows, I always play on a Minesweeper clone called Arbiter. But this board was so small and it sucks, so this was very nice to have. And it was really easy thanks to Raylib's draw texture mode. It changes the drawing canvas to whatever texture target you specify instead of the main window. And after all the drawing, I just have to call the professional version of draw texture with a scaled destination rectangle, and the board would be scaled. Now we can finally dive into the most epic part, RTX Minesweeper. You may be wondering how I'm going to pull this off. Well, I'm just using the fancy sprite I found online. This one's made by Rock Paper Katana. I'll put the source link in the description. Now I need to fix two problems. First, the relative position of the tiles is different from the one I'm already using. This means that if I just straight up load the image, the virtual rectangle will be pointing at the wrong tile type, resulting in something like this. Second, the resolution of the sprite is huge. This means that even if the rectangle is pointing at the right type, it would only render a portion of the tile, resulting in something like this. So I opened Photopea, because Adobe for its overpriced programs, and I edited the hell out of the thing. This solves the first problem. For the second problem, believe it or not, my big brain had already defined a variable called sprite size, which is the pixel size of a single tile. And the calculation of the virtual rectangle was generalized enough that I simply needed to increase it to match the pixel size of the RTX skin. And boom, everything just works. Or do they? Alright, let's build and see. Oh my god! Okay, so what happened was I was calculating the window size using the board width and height times the sprite size, and I forgot the fact that when the sprite size is huge, the window becomes massive, and that lagged the f*** out of my computer. Turns out my code was still ugly after all. But after some simple fixing, here's Minesweeper with RTX on. Let's celebrate this glorious moment by speedrunning one expert game. Sorry, my voice got a little bit deep there. Since the rendering was general enough, adding a custom thing would be simply modifying the colors of the original sprite and load the image instead. After a couple minutes of tweaking the colors, we now have a dark mode. And finally, how can I forget one of the ultimate goals of this project, the Amongus theme. Alright guys, that is the video. By the time I'm editing this, I've actually added multiple features like showing the mines, the expand groups, and cheat mode that can show you the best starting tile, immortal mode, or the ability to revive. I'll put the code in the GitHub repo. Check it out if you want. And subscribe for more suffering.